It's the first week at the Iowa Legislature, and two new people represent Mahaska County at the Capitol in Des Moines. Former County Supervisor Ken Rozenboom just started his service as a state senator. Larry Sheets was elected in November to represent the western portion of Mahaska County in the Iowa House of Representatives. State Representative Guy Vander Linden from Oskaloosa is the veteran of that delegation from Mahaska County. He's starting his second term. A number of issues are on the table at the statehouse already, including the state budget, a fiscal surplus, and education. Aaron Riggs spoke with all three legislators to find out more.
They were hired last November, and this week they finally got their feet wet.
It's kind of likened to drinking water out of a fire hose, though. It's just an awful lot all at once.
That's a good thing to say. You're drinking water from a fire hose.
There's no lack of issues or tasks as a legislator, and one of the big priorities now is what to do with some extra money. The state is starting off the year with a $1 billion surplus.
I don't think of it as a surplus. It's an overpayment by the taxpayers of Iowa, thanks to some good budgeting on the part of the legislature and the governor.
We have extra money that we've collected from people, from taxpayers. So. Appropriations, how we spend money. I'm on the Appropriations Committee, and I'm really delighted to be on that because that's where it all starts in terms of how we spend money.
And one of the big budget items every year is education. During his condition of the state address on Tuesday, Governor Terry Branstad proposed changes to the school finance formula, which may include doing away with what is known as allowable growth. Allowable growth is the formula the state uses every year to give money to schools. It's on a per student basis, so schools receive state money according to how many pupils they have. That means schools with fewer students get less money, which is especially a problem for rural areas that are losing population.
The allowable growth thing for small schools like Moulton and other schools has been sort of like the angel of death. And the fact that he's talking about getting away from that and trying to substitute something that's hopefully better, that's very encouraging.
I think if we have a system that people don't understand, it's complicated. Maybe it is time to take a look at the fundamentals.
Allowable growth triggers property tax increase, and of course we're trying to decrease property taxes, so we're sort of working at cross purposes there. I'll be very interested to see how he plans to sort this out.
And as the legislators meet for the next 4 months, their outlook is positive.
But, you know, I'm here to do the people's job, and if I can represent them, then I will have done the job I've been sent here to do.
We've got unemployment statewide down below 5%. That's the best it's been in 4 years. I think there's some indications we're making modest progress, and I want to keep moving in that direction.
I wear a different hat now, but in a way I'm doing the same thing I did back there, and that's what I consider to be public service.
If you want to contact any of Mahaska County's legislators, you can do so. The information is on your screen.